Meow. Oh, I wish they'd hurry up. Oh, maybe they're here. No, no, not yet.
Wow, is this your cousin from Mexico, Big Bird?
Yes, that's Abelardo.
Yeah, he's very cute.
Oh, thanks. Oh, hi. Guess what? I'm very excited because my cousin is coming to visit me today. And Luis and Maria have gone to the airport to pick him up. I'm not here yet. Oh, he should be here any minute now.
Wow, well, no wonder your nest looks so pretty. It reminds me of Mexico.
Oh, thank you. I want Abelardo to feel right at home.
Oh, he will love it. And we can sing Mexican songs, and he can play with this maracas and sing like this.
Yeah, that'll be great. And look, did you see the piñata?
Oh, see? I love piñatas, Big Bird. You break them open with a stick so all the toys and candy falls out. But, Big Bird, piñatas are only for special occasions.
Well, this is a special occasion. My cousin Abelardo is coming to visit me. Oh, I can't wait to see him. I'm so excited. I don't even know what I'm going to say to him, you know. I don't know much Spanish.
Well, I can teach you something special to say in Spanish.
You can? Mm-hmm. Boy, that'd be great. What is it?
Okay, manzana.
Manzana. Oh, I like it. What does it mean?
Apple.
Apple? Well, why would I say apple to my cousin?
Well, I don't know. I think manzana sounds very special.
Yeah, I guess you're right. Thanks, Rosita. I can hardly wait to say it to Abelardo. Manzana. Gee, manzana. Oh, I wish they'd hurry up and get here. Oh, boy. I better practice my Spanish while I'm waiting. Manzana. Manzana. Manzana.
Apple. A riddle.
Do you know that they don't have birdseed milkshakes in Mexico? Abelardo never had one before. But I told him they were good and he decided to try one, and guess what? He likes them.
Muy rico.
Mr. Hanford, two more milkshakes, please. Birdseed milkshakes.
Scram!
Uh-oh, that music means it's time to say adios.
Adios.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letter R.
R.
And the number 16.
16.
Goodbye.
Adios.
Coming soon on Sesame Street.
Mumford?
Mumford, do you see what I see?
Oh, dear me, it appears to be snowing on you, Maria, and nowhere else. Remarkable.
Right. Remarkable.
Toodaloo!
Funding for Sesame Street is provided in part by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting and by public television stations and their contributors.
Hi, I'm Paul.
Me and Maestro really get along well, too, so every day it's magical. Right, Maestro?
It's magical. Yeah. I'm gonna like it when you said it. It's magical.
Magical. Do you want to say it with me?
Okay, I'll put the camera.
Okay. It's magical. Okay, when we come back, we're going to be hanging out with Elmo. High five, high four.
High four.
High four.
Yeah.
There we go.
Oh. Oh, my goodness. Are you okay?
Friday the 13th.
Oh, I'm so sorry. I didn't think that...
Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome back to the Zone. As you can see, I'm hanging out with the hand in the toilet who has recently returned from a trip seeing the hand has been in... Toilets of the world. The hand has been going around and seeing various toilets in the world, and you went to Russia, Egypt, Turkey, Hong Kong, Japan, Australia, and now we're going to show the final installment of the hand's trip. This is...
Сейчас вы увидите на Cartoon Network «Тайная команда нашего двора».
कुछ तो मस्त बात है इस जगह की
गली गली में बात है इस जगह की
यहाँ है खलबली हंसी सरपंचड़ी
टिकट हो या ना हो ये गाड़ी चल पड़ी
गली गली सिम सिम गली गली सिम सिम गली गली सिम 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 गली गली सिम सिम गली गली सिम सिम गली गली सिम सिम गली गली सिम 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 गली गली सिम सिम
Un ojo se me hinchó perdí una apuesta una avispa me picó de un gran árbol me caí fui dando tumbos las rodillas me abrí me atacó un bulldog me hice un chichón Se me irritó la piel porque me rasqué sobre un clavo. Ayer me senté mañana lo repetiré.
Oh, yes, we the sun increase. I tap the cold guy, yeah, I love the fleece. Down the mill and one and train. Victoria Lima's got a meeting day. Out the yackle and hoon. Into a important house, they call me play. Tap the message. Yeah, I'm after myself for sure. All the morning, and we hope they stay here.
Girls are in the ashram. Sinekler sokar, yaşlı bir ağaçtan düştüm. Tüm dallara çarpıp dizlerimi çizdim. Kepek kovalar, kurbağalar ve telaşla koşar. Düşer yumurtalar, parmaklarıma kıymık batar. Yarın hepsini yaparım tekrar.
O meu zaito, a mosquiteira. Me devorou, de uma árvore eu caí. Além cada galho que eu bati, eu corri de um cão. Lambi sabão, me deu comichão. Trupiquei no chão, vou de farpa até meu dedão. E amanhã vai é ter repetição.
Som csupa csípés, szinte szeborít, sok ez elbevérzés. Várabáztam, ledugtam, nem maradt csontom, mely még egybe van. Kezem megmarták, megharapták, kicsit megjártam kér, de ez belefér. Remek nap volt, jól belementem, holnap újból, tutira megteszem.
If you clap three times, I will do something you've never seen before.
Well, let's clap together to see what it is. One, two, three.
Oh, I think I'm stuck.
Oh, hold on, I can fix it.
Oh, can you?
Go. I can help. Good as new.
Ooh, you're my hero.
Watch some real heroes on Higglytown Heroes next.
On Playhouse Disney.
Here in Higglytown, things all jump around, just like the Higglytown
heroes.
They all work together, making fun together. Come see the Higglytown heroes. You be Wayne, Twinkle, Kip, and Fran, all hop and pop around. Soon they'll learn about real heroes, who and why and jump around and meet the Higglytown heroes. We'll all work together, having fun together with all the Higglytown heroes. Let's all play together, save the day together. Come join the Higglytown heroes.
Wayne's Day to Shine.
You guys, let's pretend we're jet planes. Vroom!
Vroom! Vroom! Vroom!
Now let's make believe we're all fish. Glub, glub, glub.
Glub, glub, glub. Glub, glub, glub.
Pirates flew?
Aye, mateys. Spots of flu? Well, don't you worry. I'll get you better in a hurry. A doctor knows just what to do to get you feeling good as new. I'm a Higglytown hero, bold and good. I help my friends just like I should.
So work real hard, that's what we'll do. So we can be a hero, just like you. A hero just like you.
Uh-huh. There's no fever, and everything else seems normal. But let's see how bad your hearing is, Wayne. Tell me if you can hear anything. Can you hear this? How about this? How about this?
Just a little tiny bit.
Wayne, did you get your ears wet when you were at the beach?
He fell in the water when he was playing.
That's it. I'm afraid Wayne has swimmer's ear. Anytime you can't hear,
always tell a grown-up right away, okay?
That's what you said, Yubi. You said we should have told my mom. And you were right. I'm sorry, Wayne.
Don't worry. Wayne's going to be fine. Just watch.
Well, Wayne?
Hey, I can hear again.
Just give him a drop of this medicine in each ear twice a day.
Thanks, Mr. Doctor. Now it doesn't sound like everyone is talking in Martian language anymore.
Just doing my job, Wayne. Keeping people like you healthy is what I do. Now remember, medicine is something you should never, ever play with. But if you listen to the doctor and take your medicine when your parents give it to you, you too can be
Higglytown Heroes!
Hey, what's that? Oops, I guess I got water in more than just my ear. I'm sorry, Mr. Fish.
For your family to think about things you can do at home to make a big difference in the world around you. You can think about saving water.
Wonderful.
You can think about saving electricity, like this. That's terrific.
And you can think about recycling, no matter how small you are.
Good job.
The makers of Greenworks Natural Cleaners are proud sponsors of Playhouse Disney, where moms can teach their kids to make a difference in the world, and where you can watch my friends Tigger and Pooh every day.
Did the monkey mail come?
Did the monkey mail come?
Yes, the monkey mail came!
Well, who's it from?
It's from the Wiggles!
And it says, do you want to dance?
We sure do! The Wiggles are coming up
on Playhouse Disney!
Anytime! Any place!
Woohoo!
Darby is always on the case.
Hmm. Do you want to be a sleuth too?
Whenever Darby slaps on her cap.
This was a wonderful idea, Darby.
Thanks, Pooh.
She's ready to solve any mystery.
Now let's see where the finder flag is telling us to go.
Look for Darby in the 100-acre wood, along with all the super sleuths, on my friends Tigger and Pooh, every morning on Playhouse Disney.
We're playing telephone with Dave.
Yeah, Ooh will whisper a message to Dave, and then Dave will whisper it back to me. Are you ready? Dave says Biffle and Buzz is next.
You mean Whiffle and Fuzz is next?
Oh, yeah, on Playhouse Disney.
Hey, Whiffle.
Buzz, look who's here.
It's you.
We're so happy that you came. Woo-hoo. Now let's play the sneak a peek game.
Oh, what's this?
It's a curtain.
What's behind it?
A baby animal.
I love animals.
Oh.
What kind?
Let's find out. See these three shapes?
Uh-huh. There's an apple and
No, silly. That's a rectangle, a star shape, and a triangle.
Oh, yeah.
There's a clue hidden behind each shape. When we have enough clues, we can guess what the animal is.
We can do that.
Will you help?
Thanks. Let's start with the rectangle.
Which one is that again?
Oh, right. You're helpful.
Let's sneak a peek!
It's long and furry. What part of the animal is this?
It's a tail!
Good guess. Now let's go for the star shape. I've got it!
Let's sneak a peek!
Whoa!
Do you know what part of the animal that is? Good guess! It's a paw.
Hey, it's after my yarn.
Well, jump over here, you silly square. And let's try this last shape, the triangle.
Let's sneak a peek.
It's meowing.
Meow with us. Meow.
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 Meow. You called the kitten. Good job.
Hey guys, what's your favorite thing about summer?
Swimming. Lemonade.
Oh, do you want to know what my favorite thing is?
What?
Ice cream! Come on, everybody!
Playhouse Disney's helping you keep the planet clean and green. Today, learn about tree planting.
Planting trees is good for the earth.
Grab a grown-up and get more tips at PlayhouseDisney.com/green and watch Higglytown Heroes on Playhouse Disney. You go on missions with Little Einsteins. Wow. And have adventures with Mickey Mouse Clubhouse.
Hot dog!
You fix things up with Handy Manny and solve mysteries with my friends Tigger and Pooh.
Think, think, think.
Now it's time.
Ready to go.
To jump and shout and figure things out with Playhouse Disney's newest show, Imagination Movers.
Have you got a situation that needs imagination?
These four big thinkers are the ones to call.
Yeah! Yeah!
Because the Imagination Movers can solve it all.
Another idea emergency solved! Yeah.
So come get to know Mover Rich, Mover Dave, Mover Scott, Mover Smitty, and all their friends. Yeah. On Imagination Movers, Playhouse Disney's newest show, premiering in September on Playhouse Disney.
Let's go!
Chuck E. Cheese's, proud sponsor of Playhouse Disney. Where kids are encouraged to exercise. Because it doesn't just keep them happy. It keeps them healthy. And that's cool, for real.
Hey, congratulations, you found one of our Easter eggs. This is Brian Roberts, and I wanted to share with you some clips that were created during production of Wizard of Oz. Well, we have a lot of singing and dancing in this show, and so we, for the first time, actually did some choreography planning. And these clips you're going to see are of Jared Matthews, who works with us on our live shows, and that's how he knows how to bounce like a vegetable. And so this is Jared doing some videos to send to the animators to show them the choreography we'd like to see in the final show. Enjoy!
His name is Darby.
Try it now. Oh, try it now. I'm gonna need my oil can for this. Now, where did I put that thing? Boy, it's hotter than a truckload of flying monkeys in here. I'm melting. Ah, there it is. Oh, no. That's my hairbrush. Oh, no, it's just an old cinnamon bun. So that's what I did with my blue horsey. Oh no, that's a horse of a different color. Looks like we're in for some weather. Anyone seen my oil can?
Okay, take three.
Hey, you. Choose something already. Oh, take your time. If you need anything, I'll be right over. Hey, you. Choose something already. Oh, take your time. If you need anything, I'll be right over here. On the pole. Just looking? Oh, that's fine, fine. Just let me know if I can help. When you're done there, I could use a little help. If it wouldn't put you out too much. I hope you're enjoying your perusal of choices. Seems like you're taking kind of a long time to choose something here. Maybe the wizard could help with that. It's been nice, hanging out with ya. Oh boy.
Hi, I'm Joe Spadafore, the art director of Wizard of Oz.
I'm Chuck Vollmer, I'm senior concept artist.
And welcome to our behind-the-scenes art of Wizard of Oz section. And we're going to bring to you a bunch of images from the film that led to the final show. So let's get to it.
What we have here is Junior Asparagus, and he plays Darby in the show. And what we tried to do here is give Darby a classic farmhand look of the 30s or 40s. His shirt, we gave it a blue and white stripe look to kind of mimic Dorothy's dress from the original show.
Yeah, just a lot of, you know, we knew that this was a character very early on. I thought when we were going to do a parody that it was going to be like Laura Carrot or something like that being the main character, but we decided to go with Junior because everybody loves Junior.
This is Larry, and Larry plays the Tin Man in the show, and what I tried to do here was just kind of have some fun with the idea that Larry's a Tin Man and what would Larry wear, and usually what Larry would wear is very different than what most people would wear, so we tried to have a lot of fun with it and play around with the idea that he would just hop into a potbelly stove and wear that around as the Tin Man.
And something unique for this show is that we decided with all the major characters to remove the actual color of their vegetable skin that they normally have. And as you can see in Larry and in the other characters, we decided to just go full out. Like we give Pa fur, we give the
Scarecrow burlap.
Yeah, Scarecrow gets the burlap and this guy gets the tin. So he's got a little bit of rusty tin. So they still look like our characters, but you know, early on this guy, Larry actually just looked like Larry with some pieces of metal thrown on him. And then Phil Vischer saw that and said, "No, I really want to see these guys be fully the Tin Men, like almost like they've taken a complete transformation." So that's a very unique thing for our characters, especially in this show. And I think it's got a really nice look.
Mr. Lunt plays the Scarecrow in the show, and like Joe said, we had his actual skin take on the appearance of burlap and the color as well, to really play off the fact that he is the Scarecrow. And it was fun designing him as the Scarecrow with the rough hat and the patches and the torn up clothes that you would find on a Scarecrow.
Pa as a lion. Now, it's not very easy to turn a grape into a lion, and we did our darndest. I think what we got here is a pretty good solution here. We're playing around a lot with the mane on the character. In most of our shows, we don't tend to do a lot of like real hair effects that you see in, like, you know, feature films, where it's a pretty expensive thing to actually generate real hair on characters. So we tend to try to find shapes that look like hair and then paint them to look like hair as well. So for us, the big challenge on this guy was how to get that mane to look like a lion's mane. And, you know, it was like going back and forth and looking like, oh, it just looks like he's got really long sideburns to a mohawk to a... So I think we've eventually got ourselves down to a reasonable level. You know, we still essentially kept Pod Grape because all his face features are there. But add that little tail on, which people at first, I think people were a little curious about whether or not we could get away with putting a tail on a veggie. But in the movie, he's still very, very much Pa. And I think it's a fun, he's one of my favorite characters. And my hat's off to the modeling team for doing a great job to retain the look of the drawing. Okay, and here's Tutu. One of the things, this is one of my first times where I actually got to do an animal character for a VeggieTales show, and so I really kind of got into it. I was actually looking at a lot of old Disney things where I saw how they did model sheets for you know, getting pose expressions out of our character and really getting a sense of a range of emotion that this little guy could have. But the idea here was to keep him to be kind of like a dog, just like I believe Toto from the original Wizard of Oz, and you know, and just to keep him cute. And it was a little bit of work trying to retain the cuteness as we went into modeling. But again, my hat's off to the modeling team; did a fantastic job.
This is Yellow McToad, and the gag in the show is that they have to follow Yellow McToad instead of the Yellow Brick Road. And it was fun to get to do again a character with arms and legs and what you can do with that in animation as well. And it was fun putting the different outfits on him, trying to figure out how to dress a toad so he feels like he's Scottish. But this came out real well, and hopefully we'll see him again in some other shows.
All right, this is Splenda, the low-fat fairy. Now, in the film, we decided to add a sparkly effect around the edges and everything. That was kind of fun to play around with. But Brian Roberts did a great job designing this character. Had a lot of fun with the hair. This was a character that the tough part about it was being able to hide the fact that she's got all this tower of hair above her when we first see her, because all we see is this globe coming down at us and getting it her to flip, and all of a sudden we see, oh wow, you get this gigantic hairdo, you know, this 1950s crazy mountain of hairdo. I don't know, ladies, I wonder how long do you think it would take to get your hair to look that fashionable every morning? I wanted to talk about this character because it's a parody of my mom, and I even kind of made fun of the Louis Vuitton bags that are out there, but turning it into VeggieTale bags with that same kind of goofy look, and I just showed this to my mom, and the model in the film doesn't quite look as much as my mom, but my mom actually has this picture framed in the house because she's like, this is me as a vegetable. So anyway, this is really my hat's off to my mom because I love my mom and I wanted to put her in a film. This was a set that was originally the inside of the trailer. Now, every time you make a film, there's certain budgetary things that come up, and I think the very first drawing of the trailer, but we actually made it look even a little bit more disheveled at one point where the door of the fridge was actually taken off, because that's how it would have looked if you were to abandon a place. Originally, this location had a lot more stuff in it. You know, it actually looked like somebody lived there, and then Phil Vischer saw it and was just like, I don't want to make it feel like Junior's breaking into somebody's house. This is something that's been abandoned. And so, you know, we took a bunch of elements and just kind of threw them around as if somebody had decided, you know, forget it, I'm going to leave this place and I'm not going to take good care of it at all. I'm just going to leave it and whoever wants it can have it. And that's what we had kind of designed it for.
Here's a color script for the show. And the color script was started out by Brad Hicks. And then as we went through the show, we would make adjustments according to story changes and changes called for by the director as well. But this gives us basically a feel for how the film is going to move along as far as the color feel of it, the mood. It's brighter usually where, and more colorful where the moments are happier and lighter. The darker moments in the script usually represent maybe sadder points in the film or can be dangerous. But you can also, during their big escape, you can punch up the reds and make it more dramatic that way. It can be more colorful. So the color script is just basically a way of showing the director and everyone how the film's going to flow just from a color sensibility. This is the color key of the farm. What we do is we'll take the images from the color script, which are pretty small, and we'll do a larger painting then of that location, and we call it a color key. And then you're able to go in with much more detail and work out what the house is going to look like, the ground, the dirt path, the sky, the fields, whatever you need to do, you can work that out in much more detail.
And Chuck here is a farm boy, so we made sure that he got to design this set initially. Some of the other stuff, additional stuff, was done by Michael Spooner, some of the final stuff. But also another very important aspect of this set is that it had to ring, since this is a prodigal son story, it had to ring like this is like a heaven, a metaphor for what heaven was like. And that's why we added the sheets blowing in the wind and everything, because we just felt like once we added those, it all of a sudden had a very peaceful, tranquil kind of feel. Okay, note to kids, never go inside trailers when there's a tornado coming. There's always stories on the news about not doing this thing that we do in the show. Very important. Find a ditch, duck down somewhere. That's just what you got to do. Or go to your basement if you don't live in a trailer. But this was supposed to be this is one of the Brad Hicks's color keys that he had handled, and again, this was supposed to be a nice moody moment in the film, and this was supposed to be right before the big stressful tornado comes in.
This is Munchieland, and again, this is another color key by Brad Hicks, and we just really wanted a fanciful, colorful location that really just, it almost looked like you could probably eat just about anything in the place. It looks like candy and upside ice cream cones and marshmallows and just anything fun and bright, and it really doesn't, it's a very nice contrast to the farm at the beginning of the show, and it's just, Joe had a great time designing the location, and the color just really brought it to life.
Went through a lot of passes, too. At one point, we had thatch buildings, and we were like, oh, that looks way too much like, the original Wizard of Oz. And then we went to mushroom buildings, and it looked like some reject version of the Smurf village. We just decided not to go with the little mushroom place. And then the script really, in the end, directed what it was going to look like, and as it should have from the very beginning. Shame on us. And we decided, okay, well, let's just make all the buildings, the real challenge was like, how do we make this look like a place you could eat, but not look too much like Candyland? We did something like that in the Larry Boy film, and we had to just have a lot of fun thinking of things like that you could eat. That you would eat, you would munch on. I don't know if any of you munch on marshmallows, but if you do, we got marshmallows in here for you. This was a flat that was painted originally. There was a painting done by Brad Kex of it for a color key, and then I gave it to my old buddy Michael Spooner to paint it up for production, and he had a really interesting method on it, really kind of captured, I think, was what is the beauty shot for the film, where we see Haas for the first time. You know, it's a great shot. I think you're going to see it on the cover. And, you know, he had a very simple, almost graphic style. And that's another thing about this film is we never really tried to hide the fact that these are paintings in the backgrounds behind the characters. I mean, it does mesh a little bit better than, say, the live-action old Wizard of Oz film did, where the characters are obviously standing in front of painted backgrounds, and they didn't try to make it look super realistic. But we tried to do the same kind of thing for this film. We just said, well, you know, if they're looking at what looks like a painting, it's okay in this film. And here's that location as we get closer to it. It's obviously a lot more saturated now that we're, like, right in front of it. You know, we just tried to set up the color mood that this is the establishing shot of that last wonderful world. The interesting little trick that kind of happens is while you're in the park, you don't really see, or you only get slight indications of this big roller coaster, this gigantic one that goes around the whole park, because there's another roller coaster within the park. So if you pause the DVD player as they're flying out on the trailer at the end, you'll kind of see how the actual layout of the park actually looks. Actually, this big green roller coaster that goes behind them actually winds in and out of the park. So I eventually figured out how we could make this roller coaster that goes behind the whole park actually weaves around in the park. So there's a little bit of logic to it, but it's also a little bit of guesswork. And, you know, in the end, you just ask what looks good on screen, and I think it looks pretty good. Here's an example, just real quick, of how we use clouds in the film. These were just some clouds, and each one of them's on a different layer, and they're all hand-painted to look like clouds that would move in, and they each imitate just real cloud movement. But this is, again... most of the stuff in VeggieTales is all hand-painted stuff.
The nice thing about putting the clouds on different layers is that you can move the foreground clouds at a faster speed than the ones in the back or in the middle. And that kind of gives the illusion of depth. And it just makes the world feel much more alive and creates a little bit more movement in the skies so they don't feel so static. These are the set designs, drawings that we did up for the location of the farm. Again, I based a lot of my ideas for the farm off of actual experiences as a kid growing up next to my grandfather's farm and my uncle's farm. Looked at a lot of reference of old barns and farms of the 30s and 40s. And this was probably one of the most fun I've had on a location in a long time, is just kind of pulling back to old childhood memories and designing this farm. The farmhouse, I kind of designed this one off of an old abandoned farmhouse that my brother and I as kids would ride our bikes to and explore in things. And it was just a small old farmhouse and just a very simple design to it, but it just had a nice classic silhouette and look to it that just really read, you know, to me, farmhouse. And it was a lot of fun working on this. Both the farmhouse and the barn, after I did the rough designs, we had Michael Spooner go over them and work his magic and putting the finishing touches on it and the subtle details as the gobles and the window box treatments and things like that, and really give them a lot more character and charm. Well, thanks for taking a look at the visual development artwork and production artwork that was done here on The Wizard of Oz, and I hope you enjoyed it.
Yeah, thanks a lot, and I hope you all come around next time to check out our next film. It looks pretty nice, too, and we'll probably give you a little sneak preview of it a little bit later on, but again, it was a pleasure to work on. This is my first film art directing, and I hope everybody likes how it looks. Thank you.
again.
Kids, you can start with the easy questions or the hard ones. Either way, there's a reward when you get them all right.
Not now, Darby. Miss Poopsie is thirsty.
But I...
Here, Miss Poopsie, drink up. Don't get jealous, Francine. You're next.
You got it right. Here's another one.
It's ready. The floss is ready. Ha, we can pick it now, I think.
Fire up old Bessie. The floss is ready.
You got it right. Here's another one.
Beyond the barn, across Kansas, and all the way to the land of Oz.
Right. Well, remember how much your dad loves you, Darby. You really are a lucky kid.
You got it right! Here's another one.
Tin Man.
Rustin.
Hula Finn!
What? Boil spam? He wants us to boil some spam. I've heard about guys like this.
You got it right! Here's another one.
Ohioans.
And fifers.
And mares.
Oh my.
Ohioans.
And fifers.
And mares.
Oh my.
Ohioans and fifers and mares.
Oh my.
You got it right! Here's another one.
No, we're not gonna ride the roller.
What about that spinny ride where you stick to the wall?
I said no. No rides.
You got it right. Here's another one.
The story of the prodigal son is about how much God loves everyone. Jesus told that story to teach us something about God.
You're losing me, Bob.
Well, let's see if QWERTY has a verse for us. How great is the love the Father has lavished on us, that we should be called children of God. 1 John 3:1.
You got it right! Good job! You got all the easy questions right!
Uh-oh! Tutu! What are you supposed to do if you're caught outside by a tornado? Tutu, get out of that ditch and help me remember!
You got it right! Here's another one.
Look, it's a sea!
What is
that? I know! Soon explains everything!
Is there a beautiful fairy inside that big round ball?
You got it right! Here's another one.
Hey there. How's it going?
How did you find me?
You got your dog to thank for that.
So, how are we gonna get him out? We need a helicopter, 200 yards of steel cable, and a pound and a half of margarine. You got it right! Here's another one.
City, and it's looking very pretty, and we're happy, and we're hopping, and the fun is never stopping.
Hey, I don't think these are flowers. You got it right! Here's another one.
The lion, he wants cotton candy, and the Tin Man wants roller coasters. Uh-huh. And the Scarecrow, he wants one of those rides where you spin and the bottom falls out.
Oh, my. And what about you, sir?
You got it right. Here's another one.
We're gonna have a party.
All right.
Oh, yeah.
Get right on it.
I don't get it. Didn't he run off and spend all the money? You got it right! Congratulations! You got every answer right! Here's a bonus clip just for you. Thanks for playing! Darby, Miss Poopsie is thirsty.
But I...
Here, Miss Poopsie, drink up. Don't get jealous, Francine. You're next. Sorry, wrong answer. Try the next question. It's ready. The floss is ready. We can pick it now, I think.
Fire up old Bessie. The floss is ready.
Sorry, wrong answer. Try the next question.
Beyond the barn, across Kansas, and all the way to the land of Oz.
Right. Well, remember how much your dad loves you, Darby. You really are a lucky kid.
Sorry, wrong answer. Try the next question. Tin Man.
Rustin.
Oh, look, Tin!
What? Boil spam? He wants us to boil some spam. I've heard about guys like this. Sorry, wrong answer. Try the next question. Ohioans.
And Fifers.
And mares.
Oh, my.
Ohioans.
And Fifers.
And mares.
Oh, my.
Ohioans and Fifers and mares.
Oh, my.
Sorry, wrong answer. Try the next question.
No, we're not gonna ride the roller.
What about that spinny ride where you stick to the wall?
I said no, no rides.
Sorry, wrong answer. Try the next question.
The story of the prodigal son is about how much God loves everyone. Jesus told that story to teach us something about God.
You're losing me, Bob.
Well, let's see if QWERTY has a verse for us. How great is the love the Father has lavished on us that we should be called children of God. 1 John 3:1.
Sorry, wrong answer. Great job! Do you want to try again? Reading stories. Reading stories. Reading stories is really fun. Would you like to be read to, or do you want to read the story yourself?
Hello, and welcome to the Munchieland Memory Game. See if you can remember where the different Munchieland peas are. The doors will open up for a moment, and then we'll ask you to see if you can find the one we're looking for. If you find all of the peas, there's a bonus clip for you to watch. Get ready, here we go!
Where's the pea with the curly hair?
Nope, sorry, that's not the right one.
Where's the pea? That's right, good going.
Where's the pea with the eye patch? Hello, and welcome to the Munchieland Memory Game. See if you can remember where the different Munchieland peas are. The doors will open up for a moment, and then we'll ask you to see if you can find the one we're looking for. If you find all of the peas, there's a bonus clip for you to watch. Get ready, here we go! Where's the pea with the sunglasses on? That's right! Good going!
Where's the pea with the really long mustache? You found him!
Where is the pea with the white wig, mustache, and top hat? You found him! Congratulations! You found all of the peas! Now you can watch a special bonus clip!
The pea with the curly hair. That's right! Good going!
Where's the pea with the eye patch? That's right! Good going!
Where's that guy with the flower in his hat? You found him!
Congratulations! You found all of the peas! Now you can watch a special bonus clip! Where's the guy who is blowing a bubble? That's right! Good going!
Which one of the peas had a bow tie? You found him! Where's the pea with the ball of munchies?
You found him! Congratulations! You found all of the peas! Now you can watch a special bonus clip!
everyone, this is Larry. And today, we're gonna learn about the story of the prodigal son as we play the Harvest Time game.
And we're gonna find out.
I was here.
To start, you'll need to gather the following items: your favorite translation of the Bible, a stack of note cards, paper bags, scissors, tape, crayons, and pens. This is the Smith family, and they're gonna help show us how to do the activity. Parents, begin by reading the story of the prodigal son from Luke chapter 15 to your kids. And kids, be sure to pay close attention because in a minute, we're gonna test your newfound knowledge of the story with some fun questions. While you're listening to the story, draw pictures of your favorite veggies on the note cards. Once you've finished reading the story, parents can take a few minutes to write down questions on the back of the note cards and fold them in half. They could be questions like, what did the son ask his father to give him? Or, what animal was it the son's job to feed? Now take the paper bags and cut them into basket shapes. To do this, you'll want to cut down the sides of the bag, leaving a strip on each side that can be folded over and taped together to make a handle, just like this. If you want, feel free to draw pictures on your basket as well. Next, stand all the cards on a table and have each child take turns selecting them. When a card is selected, read the question aloud.
That's right.
Whoever answers the question correctly first gets to place that veggie card in their basket. Once all the cards are gone, look and see who's gathered the biggest harvest. Finally, don't forget to talk more about the story of the prodigal son and the lesson that it teaches. And remember, God made you special, and he loves you very much. And nothing you do could ever cause God to love you any less. See you next time. Goodbye.
Get out! You're out! You're out!
You're out! You're out! You're out! You're out! You're out! You're out! You're out! You're out! You're out! You're out! You're out! You're out! You're out! You're out! You're out! You're out! You're out! You're out! You're out! You're out! You're out! You're out! You're out! You're out! You're out! You're out! You're out! You're out! You're out! You're out! You're out! You're out! You're out! You're out! You're out! You're out! You're out! You're out! You're out!
Thank you. Bye.